This documentary is based off of Paul McCormack's early life and experiences in the Navy.
I was born in Jamaica, in St. Andrew. I grew up in Montego Bay with my grandmother and grandfather. It was fun, but I wanted to come to the United States because all my cousins was living in the United States. They were living with me for a period of time, but they got sent for, and I was the last one to leave Jamaica. So I was very anxious to leave because all my cousins were in the United States. I love the beach. I love fishing. I love playing soccer. Like I said before, about 90% of my family was living in the United States. I was just living with my grandmother and grandfather. And it was challenging because getting up and thinking about them every day and wanting to come to the States was somewhat depressing, but I kept busy by doing the things that I love to do. I remember getting on an airplane, and that was the first time I've ever been on an airplane, and flying over the United States and seeing the huge buildings was a culture shock for me. Getting off the plane was a culture shock for me, and the cold. I came to the United States in 1981 in October, and that's when New York is really cold in, October, and I've never felt that before, so it felt like I was in a refrigerator the whole time. So that was a shock for me as well. And just the huge building and the busyness of New York was very much a shock for me. I was 13 years old, and I was supposed to go into the eighth grade. But Jamaica, as you know, it's a third world country, and the education system there is not as good as the United States. So when I took the test, they said that, well, let's just put you in the seventh grade. So I was 1 year back coming from another country. But it was okay. I knew the subject matter, and I did well in school, but it was a different way of learning, different way of thinking. And the culture of just the kids, I had to learn how to speak proper English. In Jamaica, it's a broken English, so I was made fun of a lot with my accent. So after leaving junior high, I went to Aviation High School in Queens, and I was there for a year, but my mother wanted to move to New Jersey, where it was much more safer to raise kids. So we moved to New Jersey, and I went to Columbia High School. I started as a sophomore there, and I played soccer there. I was on a varsity team, and it was fun. I didn't take learning seriously as much as I wanted to, because I love sports, and that's what I did in Jamaica. However, I did have fun there, and from high school, I went into the military, into the Navy, the US Navy, and that's where my career started. Boot camp was another culture shock for me. It was 8 weeks of pure HEWL hockey sticks. After boot camp, I was stationed on a ship that was being built. So we for 2 years in Norfolk, Virginia, we just hung around and learned how to be a sailor without being a sailor, without being on the water. After that, we commissioned the ship, and that's when we were deployed to the Persian Gulf in 1991. At first it was Desert Storm. It became at first it was Desert Shield, And then it became Desert Storm when it we went to war with Iraq. You really don't think how it's going to change you while you're going through that experience. And you saw it as a job, not basically anything special. Yes, it's a war, but everything that you trained for, it was day-to-day things that we did. We didn't do anything special. We were at general quarters, you know, but we trained for that weekly. So it didn't seem scary at first, until we heard that there were mines in the water. And so we went to general quarters, and I was at the front of the boat, the ship, to where we, I was in charge of a few equipment down in the bow of the ship, and that's where sometimes the ship gets hit by mine. So it was scary at that time. I was an electrician, so I was in charge of all the electrical equipment, which everything that's powered by electricity, we had to do maintenance on or fix. So from the top of the ship all the way to the bottom, that was my job, to make sure that everything works. It was a great experience because I used that when I got out of the military to work at an electrical company that helped me get through college.
Paul now lives with his three young sons, beautiful wife, and two pugs in Phoenix, Arizona. He still to this day goes to the beach whenever he can. About a thing.